This dude is, he's starting to be, like, with Annie, like, a regular at these shows, man. I performed with him for the first time at our Bridge comedy show, shameless plug, last month. He's a very funny dude, all the way from Oakland, California, yeah! Make some noise!
Cruising down the street in my 6-4, jocking the freaks, clocking the dough, went to the park to get the scoop, knuckleheads out there, cold shooting some hoop. A cop pulls up, who can it be?
Yeah,
a fresh
album
in the running game.
Man, I'd rather listen to the rest of that song than my set, to be honest.
Oh, fuck yeah.
That song is fire. Anyway, I'm Eric. I like to overdress for these shows because I always, now I know what it feels like to be a substitute teacher. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. And I can tell for sure you guys are the bad kids. For sure. I know when they turn the house lights on, it's gonna be some fresh graffiti back there. But who did this? It's beautiful. I like it. Who tagged this shit? This is fire right here. I mean, can I put it on my Insta? I'm gonna put it on my gram. But yo, my name is Eric Newton. I live in Oakland, California, and believe it or not, I grew up a Jehovah's Witness. Yeah, so I've been to your house before. Yeah, who said me too? You do fellowship?
What's that?
Are you just fellowship? You DF?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I know how it works. I never got baptized, so they can't fuck with me, boy. You see, you feel me? Yeah, it's tight. I say whatever I want about their organization. I love it. But actually, you know what? I'm not even here to talk about our Lord and Savior. Actually, I am. That's why I'm dressed like this. Yeah, I'm here to talk about our Lord and Savior, Kanye West. Yes. Lord Yeezy, give me that ultralight beam. Yes. I was always a weird kid growing up. I was hell of a weird kid. I hang out with like skaters and drama kids. Some people always used to fuck with me, bro. I used to, look at Eric. He hella weird, boy. Gets his nails did. He hella soft. I'd be like, yo, don't get it twisted, son. I get my nails did, but you can still catch these hands. You know what I'm saying, boy? You can still catch these well manicured hands, dog. I'm not afraid to fight most of the time. You know what I'm saying? If you need to know, right now is not a good time because I just got them done. I'm not trying to chip a nail. All right. But check it out. I'm not afraid of fisticuffs. I'm not afraid to fight. And if I lose that fight, I'm not afraid to press charges.
No.
You know what I'm saying? I'm black. I speak with a lisp. I got my nails done. It's gonna be a hate crime.
Oh.
I'm gonna win this one way or another. What? Don't want to fight me right now. What? It's good. I've been doing comedy in the Bay Area for a long time, and it's true what they say at shows. You know, you gotta be careful what you say at shows, dude. You don't know how people will react. And I hear comedians say shocking things all the time. All right. So one time I was in San Francisco, and that night every comedian, they were all doing jokes about suicide, 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 suicide. And then eventually, even the bartender, he grabs the mic and he's like, "Yo, if I ever commit suicide, I already know how I'm gonna do it." He's like, "I'm gonna lock myself in my garage and leave my car running." And I was shocked. I was like, "Bro, you can afford a car and a garage? What?" As a bartender in San Francisco, I was like, "What?" I was like, I'm not writing no more drinks. I'm not writing any more jokes after that. After that faux pas. You know what? I'm just gonna jump out of that joke, man. I messed it up. I'm sad about that. That was the best part of the joke, dude. You guys can watch more of my shows. I don't usually mess up. Nah, that's a lie. I mess up all the time. Trick you guys. Come watch my shows anyway. You know the reason why I mess up? Because I'm getting old. I'm older now. My memory is not what it used to be. And as I get older, I have all these character flaws and I don't even care anymore. I love it. I lean into my character flaws. Like, I'm a huge hypocrite. Alright? I'm a huge hypocrite. I don't even care anymore. I'll give you a couple examples. I think it's fine for a black man to date a white woman. It's beautiful. I see it all the time. It's great. But when I see black women dating white men, I'm like, nah, cut it out. That's gross. What are you doing? Because I'm a hypocrite, right? Well, look, another thing, when I see a white guy dating a black chick, I'm always like, what, bro? You can't afford an Asian like the rest of them? Like come on, dude. What the fuck, dude? But so I'm a hypocrite. Like, here's a better example. I'm a hypocrite. I don't watch no movies produced by Harvey Weinstein, but I still listen to R. Kelly. You know what I'm saying? Ignition remix? It's the remix to Ignition, How to First Out the Kitchen, and I still rock that at parties. despite his latest conviction. Cause you know what? Yeah, that's a little bit of slam poetry. Cause he's in a slammer. You feel me? But anyway,
yeah,
where he should be. Yo, I want to be a thespian. So can I try out some impressions for you guys?
What?
Yeah, I want to try out some impressions for you. This first one. Okay. First impression I'm gonna do of the evening. This is a black gentleman from Great Britain watching a horror movie in a movie theater. All right. It's a black guy from Great Britain. He's watching a horror movie in a movie theater. Oi, Brevna. Brevna, don't go in there, Brevna. You know the killer's in your flat, mate. Brevna, no. No, pick up the telly, call the magistrate. What are you, mental? Honestly. All right. You don't have to clap, but that was rubbish. All right, it was rubbish. No, complete rubbish. This one's better. All right. This is a black dude from Oakland in the same movie theater, watching the same movie with the guy from Great Britain, all right? Yo, Aegis Elba, bruh, shut the bloody hell up, bruh. Trying to watch the movie, son. No, all right, I thought that was better. All right, this last one's the most accurate. This shit is super accurate, all right? This is a Mexican dude in the same movie theater with those two guys, all right? It's a Mexican dude. Let me see. Raiders! Hey, fool. Hey, Sherlock Holmes. Raiders! Oh, man. I have no segue for this, so I'm just gonna tell you guys. I for like a minute, maybe like a day, maybe like a week, a month, I thought I had superpowers. All right, and like, this is all that happened. One time, I ran across the street and I felt no pain in my body, and for the first time in my life, so I was like, dude, I think I'm getting superpowers, blood. Like for real, like there's no pain. So I was like, dude, what? I don't know my own strength. What am I capable of? What can I do? Now that I have superpowers, like I live in Oakland, I live in a high crime neighborhood. All right, I'm interested in the justice system. So of course, what do you guys think I did? I robbed a bank and escaped on foot. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. What else would I do with superpowers? If I could rob a bank and escape on foot, they gotta put me on fucking Roll Star Hip Hop for that, right? They have to, the headline alone, local comedian robs bank, escapes on foot, that's fire, blood. Dude, I'd be like Mac Dre in the streets. I would love to do that. But as I was realizing, I was like, okay, maybe I do have superpowers. If I do, the first thing I need to find out is, you know, how much damage can I take? You know what I'm saying? Like, am I bulletproof, right? Am I like the West Coast Luke Cage? You know, that would be fire. I was like, I need to know how much physical damage am I capable of taking? So I started dating a Mexican girl, all right? Yeah. And I come to find out, the reason comedians don't have jokes about Mexican girls, we don't do jokes about Mexican girls on stage, because Mexican girls know our one weakness, getting stabbed on stage, all right? Yeah, your career can't recover from that. You're done at that point. Yeah, you have to stop doing comedy. Basically, when it comes to council culture, Mexican chicks are about that life. Literally, they'll counsel you. You won't come back from it. Yeah. I promise you. Anybody do any self-improvement over this lockdown? Yeah, over COVID? Yeah? What'd you do?
Let me show you.
Show me, bro. Okay. I would love to see this. Are you about to do magic? Because you know black people don't fuck with magic, bro. Show me. Show us all.
Okay.
Are you about to do 100 push-ups?
No,
my set's only 5 minutes long, bro.
Shit, let me hold it. I'm going to hold it while you play.
Oh, wait. Am I supposed to give you 5? Okay, that's tight, what? Yeah!
Okay,
that's enough. Dude, that was fire though. I don't know, but I think it's what they call planking, right? That was planking?
It's a side plank, yeah.
Oh, that's so a side plank? That's fire, dude. Yeah. What? I learned some new, dude, Richmond. The only thing I knew about Richmond before I came tonight, only thing I knew about Virginia before I came here tonight was like, okay, in Oakland, there's two types of lesbians, right? They only come in two flavors, blood. Yeah. All right, there's one lesbian. She's like a pop star, hella cute as fuck, looks amazing. And her girlfriend always looks like she runs multiple trap houses in Richmond. You know what I'm saying? So I was like, oh, that's all I know about Richmond. But no, it's Libby out here. But
Yep.
Well, I guess I got 1 minute left, so I'm gonna get up out of here. I loved it here. Hey, give it up for JD, the voice party, everybody.
Yeah, I don't do this, but go ahead and break them off with a little previews of the remix.
Oh,
now,
I'm not trying to be cool, but hey, pretty girl, I'm feeling you.
Hey, I got one more. I'm sorry. You know what? That was way better than what I'm gonna end with. I should have just got off stage. But now it's too late. Now I'm in too deep. I gotta finish this shit. But it's not a problem, man. It happened to me last time. I love this. I know it works. I'm just kidding. It's not even an issue. Actually, I mean, R. Kelly can interrupt me whenever he wants.
Oh, no, you didn't.
As long as there's no kids involved. All right. So I would like to end on a serious note. That's how usually I get out of these shows. I like to end on a serious note. Before you guys remember me, let's think back to 2018. There was another Oakland resident. Her name was Barbecue Becky. Okay, Barbecue Becky. That's her actual government name. You can Google it. Barbecue Becky became famous for calling the cops on a group of black people in Oakland. They were having a barbecue at Lake Mary. Yeah, and that's all she. Before Karen, dude. Yeah, she like might be the original. Yeah, Barbecue Becky. She's old school. But then like 2 weeks after that, this lady in San Francisco, she calls the cops on this little 8-year-old black girl just because she was selling like bottles of water in the neighborhood, right? So I'm like, dude, this shit's out of control. Every day there's a new news story. I gotta say something about this. So this is how I like to end my shows, okay? Yo, if there's any white people here right now that want to call the cops on me because I'm doing comedy at an obvious illegal comedy show, you know what I want to say to you? I wish you would. Ooh. You know what I'm saying? I wish you would. Okay. But really, I wish you would because I can use the publicity. You know what I'm saying? Right. I need some exposure, people. Because we can go on CNN together or whatever. And if not, I'm also selling bottles of water. All right. Only difference is my water has trace amounts of Adderall. So it's real smart water. Hey, everybody. I'm Eric Newton, everybody. Thanks a lot. Make it roll out for your house, JD. Yeah.
The things you do reminds me of my Lexus too. That's why I'm all up in your grill, trying to get you to a hotel.
I love that song. That song's fire though.